Welcome to my channel. Today we will discuss about the numericals of calorimetry part A. So let us start with the formulas. We know in formulas we have temperature conversion. Temperature conversion, we know this formula C by phi is equals to F minus 32 by 9 is equals to K minus 273 by phi. If this, where C is the degree Celsius, F is the Fahrenheit and K is the Kelvin. Now next term is the specific heat capacity. By definition already we know specific heat capacity is the, specific heat capacity is the amount of work done required to, heat required to raise the temperature of 1 kg of substance through 1 degree Celsius. That is specific heat capacity, and formula for amount of heat is mc delta T, and specific heat capacity is Q by m into delta T. Next term is thermal or heat capacity. Heat capacity is the Q is equals to C dash into delta T, where C dash is heat capacity. So heat capacity is Q by delta T. And heat capacity C dash, there is the relation, is equals to mass into specific heat capacity. So C dash is equals to M into C. Now next part is the principle of calorimetry. What we know about the principle of calorimetry? It is the heat lost by hot body is equals to heat gained by cold body. And two more formulas are there. If anybody is falling from certain height, then what will be, like water is falling from a certain height, what will be its rise in temperature? For that we can write potential energy is equals to heat energy. Potential energy is mgh and heat energy is mc into delta T. M is mass, C is the specific heat capacity, and delta T is the rise in temperature. And one more thing, electrical power, if any term is given regarding electrical power, like electrical kettle is there, in that one we are heating water, and power is given, power rating of that is given. So power into time is the heat is equals to mc delta T. So in that case we will use power into time is equals to mc into delta T. So let us start with the first sum. So what informations are given? By imparting heat to a body, its temperature rises by 15 degree Celsius. What is the corresponding rise in temperature in Kelvin scale? So Kelvin scale may be where rehta, humne already padha hua hai ki since temperature in Kelvin increase pucha hai, it will be same. Increase pucha hai, it will be same. Nothing we have to write. So rise in temperature in Kelvin is equals to rise in temperature in degree Celsius. So therefore it will be 15 Kelvin delta T. In terms of Kelvin it will be 15 K. Now question number two, what we have? Calculate the heat capacity. Heat capacity means C dash of a copper vessel of mass 150 gram if the specific heat capacity of copper is 410. How much heat energy will be required to increase the temperature of the vessel in part A from this term? So in two parts this question we have to solve. So first of all we will write what informations are given. So mass of copper vessel m is equals to 150 gram. So m will be 150 gram means it will be 0.15 kg because other units are in kg form, MKS form. So I have to write mass in terms of kg. If a specific heat capacity of copper, that is C for copper, is given, specific heat capacity is 410 joule per kg per Kelvin. So calculate heat capacity. We know what is heat capacity. Heat capacity I have written already here, relation between that. Heat capacity C dash is equals to mass into specific heat capacity. Heat capacity is equals to, no, heat capacity is given. A specific heat capacity is given, mass is given, right. Mass is given and a specific heat capacity is given, right. So we have to find out heat capacity. So heat capacity C dash is equals to mass into specific heat capacity. So A part we can write, since heat capacity C dash is equals to mass into specific heat capacity. C is the specific heat capacity. So C dash will be, M is 0.15 into 410. So multiply it, 15, 0, 0, 15, 1, 15, 15, 4, 60, and 161. Decimal at two places. So C dash will be that much joule per Kelvin. So C dash is equals to 61.5 joule per Kelvin. That becomes answer. Next, it's B part. What it is in B part? How much heat energy will be required to increase the temperature of the vessel in part A from 25 to 35 degree? So delta T is given to us. We have to find out increase in temperature. Increase in temperature, delta T is 35 minus 25 in degree Celsius. So delta T will be 10 degree Celsius and mass is given, C is given. So we have to calculate heat energy. So we know, since Q is equals to heat energy, MC delta T. M is, mass is 0.15. C, specific heat capacity of copper is 410 into delta T is 10. So we will do smart work. Already M into C we did, that is this term, 61.5 into 10 delta T. So it will be 615 simply. So no need to do the whole calculation again. So you will get Q is equals to 615 joule. That becomes answer. Now next question is question number 3. A piece of iron of mass 2 kg, mass is given as 2 kg, has a heat capacity, it's not a specific, it is C dash, heat capacity, C dash is this. Find heat energy needed to warm by 15 degree, it's a specific heat capacity in SI. So same way as in previous question, first of all we will write all given informations. So mass, M is equals to 2 kg. And heat capacity C dash is given now, 966 joule per Kelvin, C dash, it is C dash. We have to find out heat energy needed to warm, delta T is 15 degree Celsius. Heat energy needed to warm, and specific heat capacity. Two terms are there. So just we will find out first part. Anyway, just we will proceed according to given condition. So heat energy required to warm it by 15 degree. So heat energy is to be find out and see we have to find out. तो सेम वे हम पहले एक काम करते हैं, हमें सी डैश पता है, हम लोग ये रिलेशन से दिस रिलेशन वी विल यूज सी डैश इज इक्वल्स टू एम सी, उससे हम सी निकाल लेते हैं, देन क्यू इज इक्वल्स टू एम सी डेल्टा थीटा वी कैन फाइंड आउट. और लॉट ऑफ वेज आर देयर, टू टू थ्री वेज आर देयर. तो आई विल राइट सिंस क्यू, पहले हीट पूछा है तो क्यू मैं निकालता हूं, एम सी डेल्टा टी. नाउ सी इज गिवन, नॉट सी डैश इज गिवन, नॉट सी इज गिवन. एंड वी नो वन मोर थिंग, सिंस सी डैश इज क्यू बाय डेल्टा टी, क्यू बाय डेल्टा टी, दिस टर्म इज सी डैश. सो आई कैन राइट, आई कैन राइट yes, C dash is Q by delta T. So delta T we can write delta T as C dash into Q. Okay, C dash is Q by delta T. हमें Q चाहिए तो C dash दिया है, delta T also given. We will not write this formula first. हम ये formula नहीं use करेंगे. तो कौन सा यूज कर लेते हैं, यही वाला, C dash is equals to Q by delta T. Since C dash is equals to Q by delta T, so Q will be C dash into delta T. So C dash is 966 into 15. We'll multiply 15 6 a 90, 15, 6 and 90 and 9, so 99, then 9, then 59 is 135 and 9, 135 and 9, 144, that much joule. So A part we get, its first part we get. Now about the second part, what is to be calculated? Second part mein is specific heat capacity. So we know C dash, since C dash is equals to M into C, so it implies that C will be C dash by M. So C dash we have 966 divided by M. What is mass? 2. That is, therefore we will get C is equals to half of that, 2 4s are 8. Then 16, 2 8s are 2 3s are, that much joule per kg per Kelvin. This becomes specific heat capacity. Now question number 4, calculate the amount of heat energy required to raise the temperature of 100 gram of copper from 20 to 70 degree. So mass is given as 100 gram. We have to convert that in kg. And delta T is 70 minus 20. So 50 degree. That is rise in temperature. Specific heat capacity is this. Anyway, all the informations are given. So just we'll write first of all. So given what informations are here. Mass M is equals to 100 gram, which is 0.1 kg, mass it is. Rise in temperature, that is delta T is equals to 70 minus 20, that is 50 degree Celsius. It is delta T. Okay, delta T. And specific heat capacity of for copper, C is given, 390 joule per kg per Kelvin. These all the informations are given to us. And हमें पूछा क्या है, we have to calculate the amount of heat energy required. Q is to be find out. So we can say, since amount of heat required, Q is equals to mc delta T. M is 0.1 into C is 390 into delta T is 50. So it will be 39 into 50. So it will be 1950 joule. That becomes answer. Now question number 5, 1300 joule of heat energy, so it is Q. Heat energy is supplied to raise the temperature of, mass is given 0.5 kg, delta T is given 40 minus 20, that is 20 degrees Celsius. These all the informations are given to us and hame pucha hai specific heat capacity, same as the previous one. So we will write first of all what informations are given. Given Q is equals to 1300 joule, mass M is equals to 0.5 kg and delta T, rise in temperature, is 40 minus 20 degrees Celsius, that is 20 degrees Celsius, it is delta T. Now calculate the specific heat capacity, means C is to be calculated. Again we will write, since Q is mc delta T, so C will be Q by M into delta T. Now Q is given as 1300 upon mass is as 0.5 into delta T is 20. So it will be this and this will get cancelled, 0.5 into 2, it will be 1. So what will remains? 130. So you will get C is equals to 130 joule per kg per Kelvin. That becomes unit. So this is the answer. Now next is question number 6. Find the time taken by a 500 watt heater to raise the temperature of 50 kg. This is power, this is mass as 50 kg of material of specific heat capacity. Specific heat capacity is C. C is given. And rise in temperature from 18 to 38. Delta T we can find out from here. Assume that all the heat energy supplied by the heater is given to the material. So time is to be find out. So first of all we will write all the formulas, all the values whatever is given to us. So given, I can write power, P is equals to 500 watt and mass M is equals to, mass M is equals to 50 kg and specific heat capacity C is equals to 960 joule per kg per Kelvin and delta T, rise in temperature, is 38 minus 18, so that will be 20 degree Celsius. It is all the informations are here. So we know the formula, if power is given, so regarding that, humne ek piche formula padha tha, power into time, work done is the power into time. So power into time will be equals to Q, amount of heat required, that is mc delta T. So formula already I have discussed, so we can say, since power into time, I will write once entirely, power into time is equals to Q, that is mc delta T. And hame ek cheez pata hai ki, since वर्क डन या एनर्जी इज इक्वल्स टू क्यू इज इक्वल्स टू पावर इनटू टाइम. दैट इज अ फार्मूला विच वी आर यूजिंग. सो ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ दिस व्हाट वी कैन राइट, पावर इनटू टाइम इज इक्वल्स टू एम सी डेल्टा टी. Power is 500 into time is to be find out. Here T is the time, is equals to M is 50 kg, C specific heat capacity is 960 into delta T is 20. Everything we know. So this zero cancel with this zero, 51s get cancelled. So time is equals to 960 into 2. It will be in hour. Sorry, it will be in minute. Time is in minute. Okay. No, probably. Unit of time is second, so it will be in second. No hour, no minute. It will be in second. So that much second. That much second it becomes. So therefore, time will be 960 into 2 by 60 minute. Now second 2 minute we have converted. How we can convert the, here I will write second. Now it is in minute. So this term get cancelled. Now 6 1s are 6. 16 6 are 96. So 16 2s are 32 minutes. Minute. So time is equals to 32 minute. That we get the answer. Now question number 7. An electric heater of power, वापस से हमें power दिया है, raises the temperature of 4 kg, ये mass दिया है, mass is as 4 kg of a liquid from 10 degree to 15 degree. So delta T becomes 15 minus 10. That is 5 degree Celsius. In 100 second. Time is given as 100 second now. The specific heat capacity of, specific heat capacity is to be find out of 4 kg of liquid and a specific heat capacity. Heat capacity and specific heat capacity. Two things we have to calculate. So pehle hum B part karenge. Specific heat capacity calculate kar lete. Uske baad हीट कैपेसिटी फाइंड आउट करते हैं बिकॉज वी नो द रिलेशन. सो इनिशियली वी विल राइट व्हाट इंफॉर्मेशंस आर गिवेन. सो वी कैन राइट इन गिवेन पार्ट व्हाट इज गिवेन, पावर पी इज इक्वल्स टू 600 वॉट, रेजेस द टेम्परेचर ऑफ मास 4 केजी. सो मास एम इज इक्वल्स टू 4 केजी. Delta T, rise in temperature, 15 minus 10, that is 5 degrees Celsius. So delta T becomes 5 degrees Celsius. Aur kuch diya hai, time is given, time T is equals to 100 second. Wapas se same formula, but we will find out first of all second part first. Hum pehle second part karte hain. To we know second part ke liye. Since power into time is equals to mc delta t. So power is 600 into time is 100 is equals to mass is 4 kg into c is to be find out into delta t is 5. So 5 4s are 20 C is equals to 600 into 100. तो 100 तो रहने देते, ये 600 का ये टर्म कैंसिल टू 30. So C will be 30 and 2 zeros. That much joule per kg per Kelvin. It is the specific heat capacity. Now its first part we have to calculate. So for finding first part, what we can say, since C dash is equals to M into C, heat capacity is equals to mass into specific heat capacity. So C dash, which is to be calculated as mass is 4 kg into C, we have 3000. So 3000 into 4 will be 12,000. What? Joule per Kelvin. So C dash becomes 12 into 10 raised to 3 joule per Kelvin. Yeah, kilojoule per Kelvin also we can write. 12 kilojoule per Kelvin. Depend what information is given to us. Now question number 8. 0.5 kg of lemon squash at 30 degrees Celsius is placed in a refrigerator. So mass is given as 0.5 kg. Initial temperature is given 30 degrees, placed in a refrigerator which can remove heat at an average rate of, ये रेट दिया है मतलब Q by T दिया है हमें, identify by unit joule per second, joule is the unit of heat, Q upon time second. How long will it take to cool the lemon squares to 5 degree? So rise in change in temperature becomes 30 minus 5, so 25. A specific heat capacity is given. Okay, so what informations are given? Just we can write first of all. So given mass m is equals to 0.5 kg. Delta T is 30 minus 5, which is 25 degrees Celsius. So delta T becomes 25 degrees Celsius. And Q by T ka term diya hai, joule per second, which is, that is 30 time. Okay. Anything else? Specific heat capacity is given, 4200 joule per kg per Kelvin. These all the informations are given. How long will it take to cool the lemon? Means time is to be find out. Okay. And work done per unit time is called the power. Means this term is power. This term is power. Because it is per second. So again same formula we will write. We will write again. Joule per second is nothing but watt. So यहाँ सिर्फ टर्म थोड़ा सा चेंज किया है, इंस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग डायरेक्टली पावर यहाँ पे दिया एट द रेट 30 जूल पर सेकेंड, जूल पर सेकेंड इज द वॉट, दैट इज अगेन द यूनिट ऑफ पावर. सो सेम फार्मूला वी विल अप्लाई एंड टाइम इज टू बी फाइंड आउट. वी कैन राइट सिंस पावर इन टू टाइम इज इक्वल्स टू एम सी डेल्टा टी. सो power is 30 into time is to be find out is equals to mass is 0.5, specific heat capacity 4200 into delta T, rise in temperature is 25. So this cancel, 314 za 140 it becomes, so time becomes 0.5 into 140 into 25. So it will be 0.5 into 140 will be 70 into 25. 25 is 7 za 175. No. It will be 25. Yes, 175, that much second. So it is time in second. So time is equals to 1750 divided by 60. Now it will be in terms of minute. So entirely, I don't think so, it will be cancelled. So you will get 7, 6, 2, 12, then 5, 55. 6 9s are 54, 155, 1 we are getting, 1 then
1, 10, then 10 by 6, that is 6 ones are 6, 4 and 40, 6, 6 are 36, almost that much minute time, which we can write approximate as 29 minute and 10 second. Okay. Next is question number 9. A mass is given as 200 gram of a certain metal at 83 degrees Celsius is immersed in 300 gram of water at 30 degrees Celsius. The final temperature is 33. Calculate the specific heat capacity of metal. So one metal is immersed in liquid water. So what will be its final temperature, that is to be calculated. So it is the based on the application of principle of calorimetry. So इसको सॉल्व करने के लिए हम थोड़ा एक अलग मेथड अप्लाई करेंगे. I will do like this way. here I will write this is metal. For metal I am writing, metal ka mass m1 is 200 gram, which is 0.2 kg, and specific heat capacity of water. अच्छा, इसका स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी ऑफ मेटल इज टू बी कैलकुलेटर्स, तो वो हमें पता नहीं है. दैट आई विल से एज C1. लेट C1 बी द स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी ऑफ मेटल. एंड टेम्परेचर ऑफ मेटल इज 83 डिग्री सेल्सियस. सो T1 इज 83 डिग्री सेल्सियस. ये इंफॉर्मेशन यहाँ पे. नेक्स्ट पार्ट बोला है कि इमर्स्ड इन 300 ग्राम ऑफ वाटर. मैं यहाँ पे वाटर प्लेस करता हूँ. आई विल राइट वाटर एट दिस प्लेस. वाटर, इट इज वाटर. दिस इज पिक्यूलियर वे टू सॉल्व इट, सो प्लीज फॉलो इट. वाटर का मास हमें दिया है 300 ग्राम. मास ऑफ वाटर, ओके, मास आई विल राइट m2 एज 300 ग्राम. Actually, no need to convert it, in fact. But chalega, theek hai, 0.3 kg. Zarurat nahi padega. And assuming that the specific heat capacity of water ka specific heat capacity hame diya hai per gram mein, so leave it in gram only. Because every terms are in gram. So hame C2 diya hai. C2 I will say. Specific heat capacity of वाटर. हम यहाँ W भी लिख सकते हैं, मेटल्स के लिए M एंड वाटर के लिए W. सो डिपेंड ऑन अस. सो W, C2 आई विल राइट. C2 विल बी 4.2 जूल पर ग्राम पर केल्विन. ओके, एंड द फाइनल टेम्परेचर ऑफ द मिक्सचर इज 33. मैं फाइनल टेम्परेचर ऑफ द मिक्सचर आई विल टेक एज टी, सॉरी आई विल टेक इट कैपिटल टी. कैपिटल टी इज द फाइनल टेम्परेचर ऑफ द मिक्सचर. तो फॉर दिस वन, फॉर मेटल व्हाट विल बी डेल्टा टी. ये तो T1 है, तो फॉर मेटल डेल्टा T1 क्या होगा हमारा. डेल्टा T1 विल बी किसका टेम्परेचर ज्यादा है, मेटल का. दैट विल बी T1 माइनस T. तो T1 इज 83 माइनस T, बिकॉज T हमें कैलकुलेट करना है. इट इज डेल्टा T1. एंड हियर व्हाट विल बी डेल्टा T2 फॉर वाटर. किसका टेम्परेचर ज्यादा है, मेटल का, सॉरी वाटर का कम है, और फाइनल टेम्परेचर ज्यादा होगा. सो इट विल बी T माइनस T. टेम्परेचर ऑफ वाटर इज 30. This I have not written. I will write it as T2 as 30. So it will be T2. So delta T2, it will be delta T2, it will be T minus T2 is 30. So it is delta T2. These informations are given to us. Now, according to principle of calorimetry, heat lost by hot body is equals to heat gain by cold body. We can write, since heat lost by hot body is equals to heat gain by cold body. What will get according to that? That will get M1 C1 delta T1 is equals to M2 C2 delta T2. So we'll write all the values. M1 is 200 into C1 is to be calculators, and delta T1 is 83 minus T is equals to M2 is 300 into C2 is 4.2 joule per kg it is, per gram it is, sorry, per gram, yeah, right, all right, this is per gram. So 4.2 into delta T2 is T minus 30. So overall calculation we have to do, these two get cancelled, 2 ones are 2, 2.1 because it was 4.2. So overall calculation, if we will do, we will get the final answer. So temperature part, we can write one more step. 83 C1 minus, okay, C1 is given, no, C1 is to be find out, and delta T is also to be find out, no, T is 33, sorry, final temperature is 33, so this part is given, this part is given as 33 degrees Celsius, so T will be 33, so 33 and here 33 minus 30, so 83 minus, just I will do, so finally hume kya milega, 83 minus 33, that will be 50, so 50 C1 is equals to, 50 C1 is equals to 3 into 2.1 into 33 minus 30, that is 3, so 3 into 2.1 into again 3, so C1 will be, 3 threes are 9 into 2.1 into 9 upon 50, so 9 ones are 9, 9 twos are 18, so 18.9 upon 50, so according to that final answer is, if you will multiply it by 2 and divide it by 2, so it will be 2 nines are 18 and 18 twos are 36, 137, so decimal at this place upon 100, so you will get 0.378, that becomes the final answer. So we get, therefore final answer I can write over here, C1 is equals to 0.378 kilogram, no, joule per gram per degree Celsius, or per Kelvin per degree Celsius. Okay, that is the final answer. Now question number 10. 45 gram of water at 50 degree Celsius in a beaker is cooled when 50 gram of copper at 18 degrees added to it. The content are still till the final temperature is reached. Calculate the final temperature. The specific heat capacity of copper is this, and water is this. Okay, same sum as previously we did. तो हम लोग इसका भी सेम वी कैन डू ओवर हियर. वी आर एज्यूमिंग यहाँ पे वाटर है, वाटर के लिए दिस इज फॉर वाटर एंड दिस इज फॉर कॉपर, कॉपर, कॉपर. सो मास ऑफ वाटर इज, मास ऑफ वाटर इज 45 ग्राम एट 50 डिग्री टेम्परेचर T1 आई विल से, इट इज 50 TW आई विल से, एनीवे TW टेम्परेचर ऑफ वाटर 50 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंड 50 ग्राम ऑफ कॉपर. सो मास ऑफ कॉपर, कॉपर इज 50 ग्राम कॉपर, 50 ग्राम एंड टेम्परेचर ऑफ कॉपर इज, टेम्परेचर ऑफ कॉपर इज आई विल से टेम्परेचर एज T1 एंड T2, दैट विल बी मच बेटर फॉर अस. T1 एंड T2 आई विल टेक दिस एज T1, दिस एज T2. ओके सो T1 इज 50, T2 is 18 degree Celsius. And suppose the final temperature is T, that is to be calculated. And one more thing is given, the specific heat capacity of copper, copper ka specific heat capacity diya hai, to C for copper is given 0.39 joule per gram per Kelvin, and specific heat capacity of water, that is CW, is given as 4.2 joule per gram per Kelvin. Again we will apply the principle of calorimetry. So according to principle of calorimetry we can write, according to principle of calorimetry, principle of calorimetry, heat lost by hot body is equals to heat gained by cold body. So MWCW delta T kya hoga iska, that is T1 minus T is equals to heat lost by hot body, that will be MCO into CCO, that is specific heat capacity, into delta D iska kya hoga, that will be T minus T2, because mixture ka temperature will be greater than this. So we can substitute all the values. Now we will have mass of this 45 into 4.2 into delta T, T1 minus T was 50 minus T, ये T हमें calculate करना है, 50 into 0.39 into T minus T2 is 18. So by doing all the calculation we can calculate the value of T. Okay, so I don't have that much space, so calculation part I'm leaving this for you people. Now question number 11, 200 gram of hot water at, this is mass of hot water at 80 degree Celsius is added to 300 gram of cold water. तो हॉट वाटर एंड कोल्ड वाटर, सो बोथ वाटर, बोथ एट बोथ द प्लेसेस वाटर इज गिवन. सो हॉट वाटर एंड कोल्ड वाटर आई विल से कि इट इज हॉट वाटर, वाटर H, वाटर कोल्ड, एंड दिस इज द फाइनल टेम्परेचर ऑफ द मिक्सचर, वॉट एवर इट विल बी, जस्ट वी कैन राइट. ओके सो 200 gram mass, M1 I will write. For this one, M1 and M2 will be very easy for us. M1 is 200 gram and T1 is 80 degree hot water ke liye. This is for what? Hot water. And cold water ka temperature 300, mass diya M2 as 300 gram and temperature T2 as 10 degree. Neglecting the heat, calculate the final temperature. Again, T is to be calculated. Same way, specific heat capacity of water, see yahan pe bhi hai, 4200 joule per kg per Kelvin, and see yahan pe bhi hai. It is same, 400 joule per kg per Kelvin, because it will be same. So again, I will write according to principle of calorimetry. According to principle of calorimetry. What is that? Heat lost by hot body is equals to heat gained by cold body. So directly we can write now. What we can write? M1C delta T1 delta T, not T1, and delta T will be, delta T will be, directly we can write, delta T will be, hot body is 80, so 80 minus T is equals to M2C into, what will be delta T? In this case, it will be T minus 10, that is T2. So, M1 is, C and C will get cancelled over here, don't put the value at all, because both are the waters. One is hot water, another is cold water. That does not matter. The specific heat will not change at all. So mass M1 is 200 into 80 minus T is equals to M2 is 300 into T minus 10. So these two terms will get cancelled. 82 is 160 minus 2T is equals to 3T minus 30. So 3T plus 2T, that will be 5T is equals to 160 plus 30, 190. So T will be 190 by 5. 190 by 5 will be 5 3s are 48. So T becomes 38 degrees Celsius. This is the answer. Same way, previous calculation is also there, but I don't have that much space in this case. So I'll leave it. You people can calculate it. Now, question number 12, and question number 12 is the last sum. Just before completing last sum, again, humble request to all of you, please like, share and subscribe my channel, or comment bhi kariye. Aapke comment se mujhe kafi protsahan milega, and agar acha lage to definitely like to banta hai. Fine. So back to question number 12. So question number 12, the temperature of 600 gram of cold water rises by 15 degree when 300 gram of hot water is added to it. What is the initial temperature of the cold water? Same pattern we will follow. Jaisa hum log solve kar rahe hain, to hum log ek line draw karte hain. Everything we will write here. Two terms are there, and here final temperature uska kya hai, we will write. Hame diya hai the temperature of 600 gram of cold water. To yahan pe hum pehle dal dete cold water, and here definitely fir kya aayega, hot water, and we will write all the values. For cold water, mass is given M1 as 600 gram. M1 is 600 gram. The temperature of 600 gram of cold water rises by 15 degree. So, iska final temperature hame diya hai, nahi diya hai, pata nahi. Okay. Agar hum iska temperature T1 rakhte, initial temperature suppose T1 hai, that is to be calculate. What was the initial temperature of the cold water? वो हमें find out करना है. Okay, तो fine. तो कोल्ड वाटर का टेम्परेचर, और यहाँ बोला है कि कोल्ड वाटर का टेम्परेचर विल राइज बाय 15 डिग्री, तो हमारा जो ये टेम्परेचर है वो कितना हो जाएगा, T1 plus 15, ये सबसे क्रूशियल पॉइंट है इसका। तो ये टर्म हो गया हमारा T1 plus 15, क्योंकि क्वेश्चन में ऐसा बोला है डिग्री सेल्सियस। When 300 ग्राम ऑफ हॉट वाटर, तो हॉट वाटर का मास दिया है 300 ग्राम, राइट, एट 50 डिग्री, इसका टेम्परेचर हमें दिया है 50 डिग्री सेल्सियस, राइट, यस, इसका टेम्परेचर हमें 50 डिग्री सेल्सियस दिया है। सो फाइनल टेम्परेचर इज दिस, इनिशियल टेम्परेचर, एवरीथिंग इज गिवन, एंड बोथ आर वाटर, सो स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी हम सिर्फ सी रखेंगे क्योंकि वो ऑलरेडी कैंसिल होने वाला है, तो लिखने का जरूरत नहीं है। वी कैन राइट नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कैलोरीमेट्री, ओके, इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट वन आई कैन राइट डेल्टा टी वन, ओके, इट विल बी दिस टेम्परेचर माइनस दिस टेम्परेचर, सो T1 कैंसिल हो जाएगा माइनस करेंगे तो आपको कितना मिलेगा 15 डिग्री, सो डेल्टा T1 इज 15 डिग्री, दैट इज गिवन। एंड डेल्टा T2 क्या होगा, डेल्टा T2 इट विल बी 50 minus दैट इज T2 minus T1 plus 15, that you will get 50 minus 15, that will be 35 minus T1, okay. Now we can write according to principle of calorimetry, calorimetry, heat loss by hot body is equals to heat gain by cold body, yeah, heat, yeah, anything, just we can write on behalf of that. So we can formulate it, hame kya milega, m1c delta t1 is equals to m2c delta t2, to c get cancel, now we can write all the remaining information. M1 is 600 gram into delta T1 is 15 is equals to M2 is 300 into delta T2 is 35 minus T1. So this term will get cancelled. 3 2s are 15, 2s are 30 is equals to 35 minus T1. So T1 will be 35 minus 30. So it will be 5 degree Celsius. This is T1. Okay. So last sum, question number 13. Yes, it is the last sum. 1 kg of water is contained in that much 1.25 kilowatt kettle. Calculate the time taken for the temperature of water to raise from 25 degrees Celsius to its boiling point 100, specific heat capacity is given. So just we will write time taken, हमें निकालना है. So given mass m is equals to 1 kg and power is 1.25 kilowatt it is. So 1.25 into kilo means 1000 watt. So it will be power as 1250 watt. Fine, this become the power. Calculate the time taken for the temperature of the water raised from delta T is given 100 minus 25. Because temperature rises from 25 to 100. So rise in temperature becomes 100 minus 25. And that we are getting as 75 degrees Celsius. And Specific heat capacity C is given 4.2 joule per gram per Kelvin. Okay. And time asked to us. So we know since power is Q by T and Q by T is MC delta theta upon time. So okay, just a moment. I will do one thing. हमें टाइम चाहिए, पावर दिया है. क्यू के जगह एम सी डेल्टा थीटा डाल सकते हैं, राइट? सो वी कैन राइट पावर इनटू टाइम इज इक्वल्स टू क्यू, बट क्यू इज एम सी डेल्टा टी. एंड पावर इज गिवन एज 1250 इनटू टाइम इज टू बी कैलकुलेटर्स is equals to mass is 1 kg into C specific heat capacity is 4.2 joule per gram, and we have to find it in terms of K, this one, so it will be 4200 because mass is in kg, so this also we have to write in terms of we can write yahan pe main thoda change kar deta hu. Since C is equals to 4.2 joule per gram per Kelvin, so it will be 4200 joule per kg per Kelvin. Now this value of C I am using over here, 4200 into delta T, rise in temperature is 75. So this term get cancelled. 25 5 is 25, so 5t is equals to 3 into 420, so t will be 3 into 420 by 5, that much second. And if we have to calculate in terms of minute, so we can divide it by 60, so we can write it also, time is equals to 3 into 420 upon 5 into 60. Now in terms of minute, so 6 7 ja 42, so 7 3 ja 21 by 5, it is minute, which is 10.5 minute, which I can write further as 10 minute and 0.5 is as 30 second. Time is 10.5 minute. That is the final answer. Thanks for watching this video.